Good morning and welcome. In case we don't know each other, my name is Lindsay Bell-Kerr. I have the privilege of serving as pastor at Christ Church United Methodist. I have the absolute joy of being the pastor for Millie Burt in these last few years of her very long life. I felt like I knew Millie for a while, and then I kind of look at the numbers up on the screen that she's 98, and I realize I just knew her for this amount of time. And if like me, you're seeing some of the pictures in the back for the first time, you know that we're not just celebrating a life, but in some ways, many lives that Millie lived. And I'm glad that you have made the time to be here today, because this is the most important thing that we can be doing today, is remembering Millie, celebrating her life, showing appreciation for all of the gifts she gave to us, and giving thanks for the ways in which the world is different because Millie lived. Because this is the most important thing you can be doing today, you probably have one of these on you. It turns off. It does, it really does. And I wanna invite you to actually do that, to think about, can you actually turn off your phone today? Look, mine turns the whole way off. I wanna invite you to think about turning yours off as well. I appreciate if you have some sort of medical device that's on, that needs to stay on. That's funny that that's going off while I'm saying that. Thank you, whoever closed the door. Please turn off your phone. This is the most important thing we can be doing today. I want to invite you to be fully present here. If you have other things you're worried about, you're concerned about, I just want to invite you to set them aside, because being present here for this time is the sacred task of remembering a life well lived. A quick note: if you need to use the restroom throughout this time, you can go out down that hallway on the right and the left. There are men's and women's restrooms. There are non-gender restrooms out in the breezeway, and we will have a time following the service, a time of reception, of celebrating, of continuing to share. To share stories, and on behalf of the family, I'll invite you to stick around for that. We'll have that time right outside under the canopies. So now let's take a moment and become fully present where we are. And I'll invite you to close your eyes if you feel comfortable, and to breathe in and out. And here where we are in the sanctuary is the traditional land of the Southern Pomo people. So we arrive in this space with humility, with an awareness that we are still working for justice and repentance. We arrive here trusting that God, you were here before us, that you who are the source of all life, continue to hold us together and bind us in relationship with Millie and with all those who have gone before us. We ask you to open our eyes, our ears, our very being to all of the ways you are speaking to, through, and among us today. Amen. And I'll invite you to rise in either body or in spirit, and we'll sing together, Be Thou My Vision.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Naught be all else to me, say that thou art. Thou my best thought, by day or by night. Waking or sleeping, my presence, my light. Be thou my wisdom, and thou my true word. I ever with thee, and thou with me, Lord. Thou and thou only, first in my heart. Great God of heaven, my treasure thou art.
Well, death is nothing at all. I have only slipped away into the next room. I am I and you are you. Whatever we were to each other, that we still are. Call me by my old familiar name. Speak to me in an easy way which you always used. Put no difference in your tone. Wear no forced air or solemnity or sorrow. Laugh as we always laughed at the little jokes that we enjoyed together. Play, smile, think of me, and if you want to, pray for me. Let my name be ever the household word that it always was. Let it be spoken without effect. Let the trace of a shadow on it. Life means all that it ever meant. It is the same as it ever was. There's unbroken continuity. Why should I be out of my mind because I'm out of sight? I'm waiting for you, for an interval. Somewhere very near, just around the corner. All's well.
And feel free to sing the chorus with me when it comes, if you're comfortable. Kind friends all gather round. There's something I would say, that what brings us together here has blessed us all today. Love has made a circle that holds us all inside, where strangers are as family and loneliness can tie. You must give yourself to love if love is what you're after. Open up the heart to tears and laughter and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. I've walked these mountains in the rain. I've learned to love the wind. I've been up before the sunrise to watch the day begin. I always knew I'd find you, though I never did know how. But like sunshine on a cloudy day, you stand before me now. So give yourself to love. If love is what you're after, open up your heart to tears and laughter and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. If love is what you're after, open up your heart to tears and laughter and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. Love is born in fire. it's planted like a seed. Love can't give you everything, but it gives you what you need. Love comes when you're ready. Love comes when you're afraid. It'll be your greatest teacher, the best friend you have made. So give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. So give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love.
Psalm 139. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. Where can I go from your spirit, or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the light around me become night, even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as the day, for darkness is as light to you. For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works that I know very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my unformed substance. In your book were written all the days that were formed for me, when none of them as yet existed. How weighty to me are your thoughts, O God! How vast is the sum of them! I try to count them. They are more than the sand. I come to the end. I am still with you. The dark black night.
the dark black nights. Blackbirds singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life, you were only waiting for this moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to arise.
Good day. I'm Denny. I'm Millie's son, and I'm here with Carolyn and the rest of the family. You already have seen a couple members of our family, and I'm going to read the obituary, but I just wanted to personally thank all of you for being here on behalf of the family. And you are part of our family. We had chapters in our lives with her, but you had major influence in her life. And I just wanted to say that our purpose here is to serve God and serve others. And you have served, and my mother has served, and you've done a recommended job of that. And I hope that you will hear his words, "Well done, good and faithful servants." This is my mother's obituary, and I'm old enough that I need these. Mildred Marine Burt, September 5th, 1925 through August 14th, 2023. Mildred Millie Burt passed away in Santa Rosa, California on August 14th, 2023, just short of her 98th birthday. She was born in Kansas in 1925 to the late Reverend Edward H. and Pearl Hoffman. Her educational journey began with her enlistment in the Nurse Cadet Corps during World War II. She earned a degree in public health nursing from Oregon Medical School and a master's degree in psychiatric nursing from the University of Utah. Throughout her career, Millie made significant contributions as a public health nurse for the state of Idaho and later as the director of nursing at Friends House in Santa Rosa, right here. While studying at the University of Utah, Millie met her life partner, Hinda Groner, and they decided to settle in California where they build a life together. Millie and Hinda were active participants in the Marriage Equality California Mecca, and have celebrated their longtime partnership by marrying when it became legal in California in 2008. Millie was devoted to Hinda for over 40 years and became her caregiver when Hinda became ill in her later years. Millie was an avid Stanford women's basketball fan and season ticket holder, and made it to a point to attend every home game despite the long drive to get there. Millie's exuberant face was once graced on a Stanford ticket stub and calendar, which we have those. And she loved spending time with her RV friends and camping frequently along the California coastline. Celebrating Thanksgiving with RV friends at Bodega Bay was a special time she treasured. And we will be going there tomorrow to spread her ashes at Bodega Bay, thanks to Jamie and his boat. He's going to take us out there to do that with both Hinda and Mom's ashes. Millie served on numerous charitable foundations and committees, including her work with the National Women's Historic History Project based in Santa Rosa. Millie and Hinda also served on the Roseland University Prep Support Advisory Group and raised funds to send Latino and students to college. Millie found solace and community in the Christ Church United Methodist Church, where she worshiped Her faith was an important part of her life. Just letting you know, too, when you read Psalms 139, it's one of my favorite psalms. And there is a praise song that I sit at the piano and play, that very melodic version of the Psalms 139. So it's real special. Thank you. Millie was preceded in death by her wife, Hinda Groner, her parents, Reverend Edgar and Pearl Hoffman, her sister, Shirley Gray, and her brother, Hap Hoffman. She is survived by her daughter, Carolyn, and David, her husband, myself, Denny, and my wife, Trina Burt, niece, Kathy Gray, which is here, right here, and Carol, and granddaughters, Tara, that just sang for you, Frank, Tracy, and Gabe Foster, and great-grandson, grandchildren, Landon, Elijah, which read for you this morning, Reagan, Jackson, and Millie, which was named after Mom. And my daughter Tracy brought Millie down here and had her with Mom the day before she passed. We have that picture. I don't think we have it up here because, what's that? Okay. So anyway, she is survived by her close friends, Aaron and Jamie Dunn, as well as her beloved extended family and dear friends. There's just not enough room to put all of her extended friends because you are them. But if you want to see it in print, we can make up a special one of these for you. So she was a true trailblazer and broke down barriers in both her career and personal life. Millie will deeply be missed by all who had the privilege of knowing her. Her legacy as a loving mother, grandmother, and friend will be forever be cherished.
There's a lot of a life to remember. We're going to take a moment and remember Millie's life together. So I'm going to start with the immediate family. I'll bring the microphone around, and I'll invite us to take a moment. I'm going to invite the immediate family to take more of a moment, if they want to share. If they have reflections on Millie's life or a story you want to share. And after each person we hear from, we're going to say, we give thanks for Millie. So let's practice that together. We give thanks for Millie. Who from the immediate family wants to share? Denny, do you want to share? It's okay if you don't. Here you go.
I just heard from my sister, don't be too long.
Always good advice.
She's been bossing me my whole life.
Yeah.
Anyway, so I'll take the short version. Mom was a nurse, you all know that. She headed up the health nurses in North Idaho, where I was from, and they used to come to the schools and give shots, and real quickly, she always made me get out of the classroom and go out and stand in the front of the line to pretend that it didn't hurt. Okay, and I did that for years until I got to be a teenager and decided I was gonna mess with her, and I pretended to faint, so anyway. That was the last time she asked. But we would come home sometimes from school, and later on when Mom got off work, we'd open the fridge for something and we'd see the vial of medicine in the fridge door. And that meant we were getting a shot that night.
Mm-hmm.
So I was gonna psych her out that night, and I went to bed early, right? Had a dream I was in the war and got wounded. I woke up with a sore arm, and I did have a sore arm because she gave it to me in my sleep.
And we say, we give thanks for Millie. We give thanks for Millie. I just want to say, I give thanks for all nurses and for all
those people who work in public health. Let's say again, we give thanks for Millie. Give thanks for Millie. Others.
So I have great memories of coming to San Francisco to see Grandma. She would take me down into the city. She would pick me up. That was before I would fly into Santa Rosa to see her. So I'd fly into San Francisco. She would pick me up. She would take me all over the place to the landmarks, Delancey Street, to have my first Irish whiskey when I was of age. And that's at the Buena Vista. And she took me to see Phantom of the Opera. And it was a surprise. So she had this whole huge day planned, and she took me, and I just was enthralled with it. And I remember she turned over to look at me and just saw the look on my face, and you could tell she was so pleased. And she just took great pleasure in the fact that it was a first, you know, Broadway play, musical for me to see. And she just really always was about the experience with both my sister and I. And we never had a doubt that she loved us. She always told us, she showed us. And you'll see in this slideshow, when she loved you, she would lean in, both literally and figuratively, and she would just lean her head against you. And you'll see in so many of these pictures her doing that with her loved ones. So, yeah.
Say we give thanks for Millie. Others. Any others? Linda, we'll go here and then to you. No, go ahead, that's fine. We'll come to you in a minute.
I met, is it on?
Yeah, let me, all right, I'll hold on to it. Go ahead.
Yeah, I met Millie and Hinda at Stanford University.
Hold on 1 second. There we go. Go ahead.
So I met this lovely couple at Stanford University at Maples Pavilion for the Stanford Games. We were in the same section, and these two just drew my heart to them. And as we started talking 20, 25 years ago, and we found out we were both from the same area. So it was lucky enough a few times that we traveled together, but we always talked because we were in the same section, and Millie and Hinda were sitting on the aisle seats, so we always got to run by. And it was just such a joy to see their faces and the love between the two of them. Because as the years went on, it was harder and harder for Hinda to get up the steps to get there. But they kept going as long as they could with exuberance and joy.
We say we give thanks for Millie.
We give thanks for Millie.
We also, because I hope Millie's watching, we also give thanks for the Stanford women's basketball team. And we are praying for a winning season this year.
I just remember Millie as one of our influencers that helped us become a reconciling church at this church. And she was a big part of our lives for so many years, and we loved her in so many ways.
We say we give thanks for Millie.
Go here and then to you. Go ahead.
My name's Phyllis Ucina, and I met Millie on her 70th birthday. She was going kayaking, and we went kayaking with her. And she and Hinda became a huge part of our lives. Barb here with me. And one of the things that I am always grateful for, it took me 20 years to work through my education journey. And Millie was always so proud of me. She would say, have you made that bachelor's yet? And then, have you made that master's yet? And when I got my doctorate, it was just joy for her. And so I can't thank her enough for that encouragement. My family's far away, and she brought that peace to me. So thank you.
We say we give thanks for Millie. Thanks.
Millie and I grew close together because we were lay members to the annual conference 2 years in a row, and we spent a lot of time talking about what was going on and standing up for proudly with our reconciling sashes. And I just loved the heck out of her. She was such a good person for me to share my life journey with, and I got to hold the huppah when they got married, and it was one of the things I'll always remember with joy about that day.
Millie. Others. If folks on Zoom want to share, feel free to raise your hand, either your real hand. Let's go to Claudia. And then others, you can raise your fake hand on Zoom, too.
Now I can't see you, but I'll just talk. Millie and I shared September birthdays, so we used to celebrate those with Hinda. And then the first year of the pandemic, up till when Millie had her stroke and when I got sick, I would go up there on Sundays for church, for Zoom church. Our computer challenges were innumerable. In fact, one time I said to her afterwards, "For the third time today, I'm swearing at a computer." And she said, "Maybe it's time for a drink." I remember that. And then also, I also remember sitting there, you know, watching church. You know, we liked watching the congregation and seeing people. And I remember one time she said to me, "Claudia, there's a way this is even better than being in church, because we can talk and while we're watching." So I'm just really glad I got to spend that time with her. And it was really fun and precious to me. And warrants another thank you to the Zoom people that make that possible and make it possible for us to be here today. So thanks mainly for Millie and also for the Zoom people.
Talking through the sermon, so I'm totally fine with that. We give thanks for Millie.
I remember you coming on those Sundays, and because I live right next door, and they were in the computer room, which is really close to, you know, my porch, and you two would just laugh and have fun. I thought, that is church, man. The endurance of church. So every Sunday you had a really good time, and I could hear it.
But they never laughed during the sermon.
Thanks, man. I appreciate that. And we give thanks for Billy. Actually, I think every time I interacted with Millie, it was funny and we had a good time. Even the last time I saw her, when she was aware she was dying, we were still talking about basketball and we were still laughing. For that lightheartedness and that way of finding joy in every moment, I say we give thanks for Millie. Others.
Hi, I'm Anna, and I met Millie through book club originally, and then we just kept kind of merging with camping and other things. And you know what really speaks to me is really her deep capacity to have joy for others. I mean, she inspired us. She and Hinda got married, and there's a long story for me on the process of coming out and dealing with my own sexuality, and there was just that joy and honesty and clarity to it that was so inspiring. And my wife and I got married, I guess 5 years after them, something like that. My math isn't the best, but she lit up at the concept of our marriage, and after we got married, and they took us to dinner, and there was just this deep joy for us of our joy. And I'm hearing that from everyone else of just how much she loved people succeeding and doing well and enjoying their lives, and how that joy brought her joy. So
we say we give thanks for Millie. Others. All right, let's take a moment and just breathe in and out. And we do give thanks for Millie. We give thanks for all she meant in this community, for her long life. We're going to take a moment now to sort of watch a slideshow of the many pictures from Millie's life. So I was just talking with Denny and Carolyn, and they were saying how many pictures there are. So we're going to take a moment and enjoy these photos. take a minute and let's pray together. Holy One, source of all life, we give you thanks for this life in particular, for this wonderful, fearful, remarkable, joyful, beautiful, thoughtful, caring life of Millie Burt. We give you thanks for all of the ways we have been able to celebrate her life today. And we give you thanks. Give you thanks for the memory of her life, that it may be a blessing to us. Amen. I just want to say a few words to maybe pull together everything we've heard today. I so appreciate the reflection on Millie's capacity for vicarious joy. I so appreciate the reflection on that, because in my line of work, you might imagine, I go to a lot of funerals, and I walk with a lot of people through the death and dying process, and I accompany a lot of people's families, and I have come to believe that there is one thing, a single thing that leads to, that quite frankly leads to peaceful aging, and it's the capacity for vicarious joy. Vicarious joy is the thing that separates people who are joyful at the end of their lives and people who are embittered. I've only been in this work for 10 years, but each year I am reminded that this is true. Because as we age, and I hope that each of us has the opportunity to age to be 98 beautiful years old, things change. We lose capacities. We lose people we love. Our bodies work differently. I don't have to tell some of you that. I'm in the process of discovering it myself. And what allows us to still be fully alive is to have joy for other people, rather than to focus on what we have already lost, on the harms that have been done to us, on our own griefs. If we can have joy for other people, we can continue to be fully alive. In John 15, Jesus says, I have told you these things that you may have joy and that your joy may be complete. Jesus' ministry, I think, comes down to this, that Jesus wants everyone to have abundant life. And in John 15, he goes one step further and he says, I want you to have joy and your joy to be complete. The thing about joy is that it is only truly complete when you can have it for other people. That's what separates joy and happiness. It's only truly complete when you can have it for other people. And I think you can only have joy for other people when you know joy yourself. I personally give thanks for the joy that Millie and Hinda had together for 42 years. It's a remarkable thing, actually, for people to be able to find any love in this world at all, and to be able to have found love like that when they did, at the time, where the world was 42 years ago, is a remarkable thing. I'm glad we chose this passage, Psalm 139, today, right? Because as the psalmist writes, I praise you, God, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I had a professor in seminary who says, if God knows us and God made us each the way that we are, then it is actually an abomination to not live into our full selves. It is going counter to the love of God to not love who we were made to love and to not be who we were made to be in this world. If each of us is made fearfully and wonderfully and differently and uniquely, then we are tasked to love in the ways that we have been made to love. For those of us for whom loving who we love and being who we are goes against the grain of this world, it is a fearful task sometimes to be out and to be ourselves. And I for one, I give thanks for the fact that I live in a world in which Millie and Hinda were out and were honest about their love for each other even before I was alive. What a remarkable world to live in, that there were people who were brave enough to love each other and to love themselves. So when people like me and people younger than me came into this world, there were people who were already showing us how to be our full selves, how to live wonderfully, fearfully, and beautifully as we were made. Sorry. It was not so long ago, quite frankly, that many of us were gathered to celebrate Hinda's memorial service. That's often how this goes, right? When people are paired like that for years and years, sometimes it's a matched set that felt like that was true for Millie and for Hinda. And at Hinda's service, right, we all, the reference to the chuppah aside, we remember that Hinda was faithful in her Judaism. And one of the things I appreciate about Christianity is that we are inheritors in some ways of Jewish tradition and of Jewish understanding of loss and of death. And in the Christian tradition, when someone passes, we say, may they rest in peace. That's a good thing. We want people to rest in peace after they're gone. In Judaism, we say, may their memory be a blessing. I love these things side by side because my hope upon all hope, my hope that is in Christ alone, is that Hinda and Millie are at peace somewhere together. My hope for us, my hope for now, is that their memory would be a blessing, that we would remember that we are to live differently because they lived before us and with us and among us, that the world is different because they lived as they did. At a memorial service, part of it is giving thanks for someone's life and remembering how they were, and part of it is also remembering that we still have lives to live, that each of us has this day, and that we will have days to follow, and that we have the opportunity to live and to be in the world differently because of how Millie lived her life. I want to invite you, if up to this moment you have not been living as your full self, start being your full self today. If up to this moment there has been a part of you that you think is unlovable, trust me, you are lovable just as you are, as God made you. Even as the world has damaged you, you are lovable, you are beloved. Live as if you are. I only got to know Millie in really the last few years of her life, and I have to say, every time I went through the door into her home, I felt like I was loved in a way that I did not fully deserve. I was hugged and I was held and I was attended to and I was cared for. I want to remember how much Millie loved me so I can remember how much I'm supposed to love myself and how much I'm supposed to love other people. If you have been living in such a way that you have not remembered you're loved, you are loved. And remember, each person you meet is as loved as you are. I would also invite you to remember that if you have not been living for other people's joy, today is the day that you can start living for other people's joy. Today is the day that you can find joy, that you can find joy in what others are doing, that your joy can be complete upon seeing and being in the joy of other people. Today is the day that you can do that. And perhaps the best way that we can honor Millie's life, particularly these last years of her life, is to have joy for other people. She had joy for us. Let us go forth and have joy for others. I appreciated what I heard Denny say, Christian discipleship. I'm a Christian, you could probably guess. It would be awkward if I told you now I wasn't. Serve God and serve others, right? I do want to acknowledge, before we conclude, we've named that family and friends are here today. Millie's caregiver, Liti, is also with us. I want us to remember and lift that up. Millie, who served so many other people, also was served by someone who cared and loved for her. We have the opportunity to serve other people. We have the opportunity to serve other people with joy. We have the opportunity to serve other people as if they were the most beloved person in the world, because they are. If we want to make a difference in this world, if we want to live in a way just that our joy would be complete, I think today we can make the decision that for however many more days we have on this earth, we will live to serve others. I give thanks for Millie's life. I give thanks for the ways in which she made a way for all of us. I give thanks for the ways in which her joy was complete because she shared joy with others. And I give thanks for the way in which one final time she has brought us together, that we might know the love she had for us, for this world, and we might love one another better because Millie Burt lived in this world. Thanks be to God. We'll sing together now. His Eye Is on the Sparrow. I'll invite you to rise in either body or spirit.
Feel discouraged. Why should the shadows come? Why should my heart be lonely and long for heaven and home? When Jesus is my portion, my constant friend is He. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. And I know He watches me. I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. For His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. Let not your heart be troubled at the word I hear. And resting on His goodness, I lose my doubts and fears. When though the path He leadeth, but one step I may see, His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. And I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. For His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. Whenever I am tempted, whenever clouds arise, when song gives place to sighing, when hope within me dies, I draw me closer to Him. From care He sets me free. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. And I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free.
and his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me.
Just a reminder, immediately after this, we can head out the double doors there. There's canopies up to, you know, protect you from the blistering heat, and there's a full spread of food. The way it works in the United Methodist Church is that we're not allowed to have alcohol, so I know Claudia said there would be drinks or something, but that's not what's going to happen. But you can't leave until all the food is gone. So we're gluttonous in other ways. You need to stick around and help us eat these dishes, and we'll have some opportunity to share and continue to share stories from Millie's life. Let's take a moment together. And Holy God, we give you thanks for Millie's one wild and precious life. We give you thanks for all that she meant in this world. We commend her spirit unto you, keeping her memory for ourselves. May it be a blessing to us. May we go forth in your love, remembering that we were made to love one another. May we go forth in the grace of Jesus, remembering that our joy is most complete when we have joy for one another. May we go forth now bound together by your Spirit, that we would live in fellowship and love and service to one another all the days of our lives. Amen. Thanks be to God.